Basically, any patient who has diabetes is susceptible to developing diabetic retinopathy. So it doesn't matter if the diabetes is well controlled or not. The patient with normal vision and well controlled diabetes also can develop diabetic retinopathy. So initial stages, when the patient presents with no symptoms and comes for a regular checkup, it may be a minor trivial things like refractive error or cataract, which can be easily tackled. So initial stages also, diabetic retinopathy can be seen where it can be not causing any visual symptoms. So when the visual symptoms arise, actually the disease is already advanced. So when the patient comes as a routine to us for eye examination, we dilate the pupils and check his fundus to look for diabetic retinopathy changes. And when there are these changes are seen, we advise the patients to have a regular examination. Even if the fundus, if the retina is normal, we still need to have a regular checkup in spite of a well-controlled diabetes. So when these symptoms arise, patients have undergone through the investigations, and then we subject these patients to certain treatment modalities. Most common treatment that we offer the patient depending on the disease level and severity includes laser photocoagulation, intravitreal injections, where injections are given into the eye. So intravitreal injections given in the eye are basically a short gap treatment to control the disease and not a cure. So there may be a repeated sessions of this treatment that may be needed. When the patient comes after in a very advanced stage, sometimes we need to take up the patient for surgery, a retina surgery, which is a different surgery from cataract. Where the disease has advanced to so much that the intravitreal injections and lasers are not able to control the problem. In such cases, we need to go in the eye and remove the blood and all the offending factors which are causing vision impairment. All said and done, it is always better that we heard about the saying called prevention is better than cure. So whenever possible, we should be able to prevent the disease. That's the first step. And whenever the disease has advanced to a certain level, it's always better late than never. So even if the disease has advanced, we still try to resolve the disease and help to stabilize the vision, and in certain cases help improve the vision as well. But even if everything is lost and vision is lost, there are still certain stages where we may have to stabilize the vision and prevent further loss. So each of these treatments may vary, and the treatment may differ from one patient to the other. It is not a kind of a uniform blanket treatment as like cataract surgery, and each treatment needs to be customized based on the patient's need and the level and severity of the disease.